I want to tell you now, pretty mama, since the day you put me down, I've been riding a lot on this old freight train, going from town to town. Gonna ride around forever, I got nothing more to lose. I'm heading back on that steel wheel drive. Goddamn old freight train was all blue. There's lots of beaches down in Georgia. Yes, in California.
I came here to see Hobo Jack from Wilmington, Illinois, and special trip just to see Hobo Jack. And now that I'm here, I'm not leaving until he's finished playing.
My name's Doc Bennett. I do artist promotions here in town and sound gigs, and it sure was a pleasure to have Jack here today.
Now, what town are we in again?
We're in Nashville, Tennessee.
Oh, yeah, this is the Nashville skyline. There we go. Yeah, and how long you been doing that, Doc?
About 7 years.
Wow. So were you from Nashville originally?
No, Cleveland, Ohio originally, the home of rock and roll.
Oh, okay. Cleveland rocks.
It does.
Yep, not like St. Louis. Actually, you guys claim it, but we invented it.
Well, we got the museum.
Yeah. Yeah, you got one on us here, bro.
Hey, buddy. How are you? Waiting in the store. Waiting in the store. Do you like it? Jack's going to be on the show again. And I was talking to him, and I told him about our store in Nashville. And he goes, I've never been to Nashville. And I was like, what? A guy like you, all the miles you put in, all the windshield time, never been to Nashville. I go, you're coming to Nashville, and I'm paying for it. I want you in my store. I want you playing here. Because out of all the people that we picked, Hobo Jack has probably made the biggest impact, I think, on everyone. And from just maybe the items that you have, or the hardcore bartering that you and I were doing, or you know, the story, or your love of Victorian antiques and your quest to save them throughout your life.
Well, the new show, and I hope you get this on there, you somersaulting out of the window of a shed is going to that's going to really make the whole program.
Yeah, I crawled into one shed on Hobo Jack's property, and I couldn't get out, so I just thought I'd try to get out the window, and I ended up, like you said, somersaulting out of the window. But in fact, I was getting into places that you hadn't been in a long time. You were picking with us.
That's true. Mike has a way of finding things. It's almost like he can smell motorcycle parts. I didn't know I even had them. I had them so long I'd forgotten that they were there.
Well, thank God you preserved them, you know, and I think that's what's cool about the show is people like you and a lot of other individuals that we come across on the road. Hobo Jack was buying this stuff and collecting it or coming across it before it was worth anything. I mean, it was really worth nothing back then, but it was worth a lot to him, and he saw the vision as far as like the history of it and wanting to preserve it and how important it was. And that's why I pitched the show for so long, for 4.5 years, is because I was meeting actually no one exactly like you. There's no one exactly like you, but a lot of people on the back roads of America that were telling me these amazing stories, and all these things were unfolding in front of me, and I wanted to be able to document that, so I started taping myself, and then 4.5 years later, we had the show. But when I run into guys like you, it reminds me of why I do what I do, because, you know, there's a lot going on now. You know, we got 10 people up in our grill all day long filming us, and, you know, sometimes you can kind of lose sight of what's important to you and why you started down a certain path and journey, and then you realize how important people are in your life that you've surrounded yourself with, and you're one of those people. So I wanted to let you know how blessed I am that I met you, and how important it is that we tell your story again and again and again, because you are the true American treasure. This guy right here.
Thank you for that very generous compliment. I don't know if I really deserve it, but I do appreciate it.
All right. Well, thank you so much. Thanks for coming here. I tried to get Hobo Jack to fly. He says, I don't fly. I say, all right, we're driving.
Flying is for the birds.
So he's here, and treat yourself to some of his books and his DVDs. He's incredible, and he's got a lot to say, whether it be through his music or through his pen or just talking to him. If you got a chance, he'll bend your ear a little bit. And so thank you guys all for coming, and look forward to your next set. Here you go, buddy.
Banjos are never in tune, Jack.
That's why they made them.
It's some strange illusion if you think they're in tune.
Pickers always want to buy the things that I don't want to sell.
Right.
One of the things that they said to me the last time they arrived there is, well, you know, you're almost 80 years old. You know, when you die, you can't take the stuff with you. And I tell them, well, I'm gonna hold on to it just a little longer because I want to see what UPS or FedEx would charge to ship it.
You may call yourself the meanest gal in town.